Hello, Herd. Gary here. Following the instances of a small number of defective early production run Intuvia 100 controllers, there's been discussion in the group about what to do and what are the upgrade options. To quickly recap, if your Intuvia 100 display is having issues connecting, your Gazelle dealer will replace it under warranty, free of charge. As for the upgrade path, one option you might consider is the Bosch Kiox 300. At about $140, it seems quite reasonably priced given the feature set and color screen. The Kiox 300 has navigation which the Intuvia doesn't. It also has fitness tracking which the Intuvia does not. Your Gazelle dealer can easily get the Kiox and the mounting arm, which is different from the Intuvia's. If there's no Gazelle dealer nearby, the parts are available on Amazon. I'll note they're not sold by Amazon proper. They're sold by independent bike shops through Amazon. Another option is to use the Flow app in conjunction with your own smartphone as your display. You can use your current phone mount with the app. Bosch does make a product called the Smartphone Grip. It's what I'm using currently and the one you're seeing in this video. Earlier I mentioned a different mounting arm necessary for the Kiox 300. That same mounting arm works interchangeably with the Smartphone Grip, so you could switch them out when you wanted to. I paid $41 and change for the mounting arm I bought. The Smartphone Grip was $52, so altogether I'm about $100 in. Wireless charging allowed me to justify it to myself. Wilma wanted to know if the Smartphone Grip is secure. My experience is that it's very secure. In fact, it takes a little work to get it in the clamp thing. I was also impressed to see that the holder is designed in such a way that it holds very securely, but doesn't press the side buttons on the phone. Jack wanted to know about phone charging capability. The big benefit to the Smartphone Grip is that it will charge your phone wirelessly as you ride. If your phone doesn't support wireless inductive charging, you can use a micro USB-A to lightning cable for an iPhone and a USB-C cable for your Android. Here's a brief overview of the Flow app. This is your primary screen. You can see it displays your riding time, distance, and average speed. There is a convenient display of your remaining battery percentage and your estimated range in the Eco or Green mode. The range estimation will change based on the mode you select. In the lower right corner, you have your headlight status, your cell phone battery status, and the time of day. On this screen, accessed with your thumb on the remote, you can review your cadence and your power wattage generation. On this screen, you'll find your ascent, altitude, and maximum altitude. These values are actually taken from your smartphone's altimeter and barometric pressure sensor. As an aside, Bosch engineered and manufactures the sensors found in both iPhones and Android phones. When you turn off your Gazelle e-bike with the Bosch smart system, it locks the motor, making it unusable by thieves. This is just a very quick look at the Flow app. I'll do a more comprehensive video in the future. Thanks for watching. Rather than beseech you to subscribe, I think I'm going to sign off my videos with a silly phrase I made up to make my kids giggle when they were young. Thank you very much. It's good to be here. Glad you could see me.